A very warm welcome to Choral Evensong here at Chester Cathedral, whether you're with us in person or joining us online. Today the Church gives thanks for the life and ministry of Thomas Cranmer, Archbishop of Canterbury under Henry VIII and Edward VI, able to bring in Protestant reforms, but then imprisoned and martyred under Mary I. His prayer books, the basis for the Book of Common Prayer we use today, have become a lasting treasure of the English language. And so we sing from the green hymn book in front of you in the stalls, hymn 224, For All Thy Saints, O Lord. Evensong continues with a psalm set for this evening, 106. We sit as the choir sing the psalm and stand for the Gloria at the end.
Thank you.
The first reading is from the prophecy of Jeremiah, chapter 9, beginning at the 17th verse. The prophet warns the people will mourn when the judgment of God comes upon them. Thus says the Lord of hosts, consider and call for the mourning women to come. Send for the skilled women to come. Let them quickly raise a dirge over us, so that our eyes may run down with tears and our eyelids flow with water. For a sound of wailing is heard from Zion. How we are ruined, we are utterly shamed, because we have left the land, because they have cast down our dwellings. Hear, O women, the word of the Lord, and let your ears receive the word of his mouth. Teach to your daughters a dirge, and each to her neighbor a lament. Death has come up into our windows, it has entered our palaces, to cut off the children from the streets and the young men from the squares. Speak, thus says the Lord, human corpses shall fall like dung upon the open field, like sheaves behind the reaper, and no one shall gather them. Here ends the Old Testament reading.
Thank you.
Second reading is taken from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 13, beginning at the 31st verse. Jesus laments over the city of Jerusalem. At that very hour, some Pharisees came and said to him, "Get away from here, for Herod wants to kill you." Jesus said to them, "Go and tell that fox for me. Listen, I am casting out demons and performing cures today and tomorrow, and on the third day I finish my work. Yet today, tomorrow, and the next day I must be on my way, because it is impossible for a prophet to be killed away from Jerusalem. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the city that kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to it. How often have I desired to gather your children together, as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, and you were not willing. See, your house is left to you, and I tell you, you will not see me until the time comes when you say, 'Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.'" He ends the New Testament reading. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. This evening's anthem, O Lord my God, sets verses from Psalm 22, including words used by Jesus from the cross. The music was written by Pelham, Humfrey for the Chapel Royal in 1674.
Thank you.
Let us pray. As we remember Thomas Cranmer, so we pray for those who lead the church in our generation. For Justin and Stephen, our archbishops. For Mark, Julie and Sam, our bishops. And today within the diocese, for the benefice of Barthamley, their parish priest, Peter Enyon. The Anglican Communion for the Diocese of Quibet in South Sudan. And with our partners in Melanesia for the Diocese of Vanuatu and New Caledonia, and for Bishop James. We pray too for those still facing persecution as Cranmer did in this generation. And for the life of this cathedral church, for our staff and volunteers, particularly this evening for Matt Forster, Andrea Boyd-Gee and Monica Escobedo. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the world Christ came to save, particularly praying for peace and reconciliation in those places where there is conflict and division, for Israel and Gaza, for Ukraine, for Sudan, Yemen, and Haiti. We pray for wisdom for the leaders of the nations, for our own government, and all those working to build a better future for forthcoming generations. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Remember before God all those known to us in particular need, and those with no one to name them in prayer. Pray for the sick at home, in hospital or nursing care, naming before God particularly Peter Jenner and His Majesty the King. We pray too for the homeless and the refugee, for the elderly and isolated, for those trapped in cycles of debt and addiction, for those struggling with their mental health or with relationship breakdown. We pray that they may all know God's peace with them through the hours of this night. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And as we give thanks for all those saints who have gone before us, we pray too for the repose of the souls of Alan Wilson, Bill Burgess, and Mary Atkins. For all those who will die this night, and for those who mourn, that they may be comforted. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We conclude with a prayer of Thomas Cranmer's. To the Holy Spirit who sanctifies us, with the Father who made and created us, and the Son who redeemed us, be given all honour and glory, now and forever. Amen. We pray together. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Amen.